Is anyone please respond? Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir. It's audible.
Yes, sir. Now it's audible.
Hello.
Hello.
Sir, it's audible.
Am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Hear you.
Yes, sir, it's audible, sir.
Okay, students, does anyone have any doubt regarding the last class? Today we are going to solve a numerical, okay? The derivation part we did in the last class. So today we are going to solve a numerical. I have already provided you the notes. I think all of you have with that. So we'll solve a numerical today by using the derivation what we did in the last class, okay? All of you please take out this numerical, okay? We will solve this numerical today. I think all of you have that with you. Go step by step how we need to solve this numerical. So what we basically need to find out, as you see in the question it is written that determine the centroidal principle MOI, means moment of inertia, of the equal angle section as shown in the figure. Okay, in the exam you will get a figure like this on that L section. Are you able to see this section, L section? You will get that type of figure. The dimension will be given. So for this type of section you need to find out that moment of inertia. Okay, so for that what we need to do, first we need to do the naming of the section. As you can see, we have named the section as A, B, C, D, E, F, like that. Okay, so now we're going to solve this numerical by step by step procedure. So what is the first step for finding out this? So in the first step we need to find out the centroid position, because as you can see, this is not the exact section. When we cut this section in the middle portion of that, we will not get the exact image of each other. So we can't say that centroidal moment is here or there. So we need to find out that position. Where is the centroid is present? Okay. So for that, we need to find out the centroid position. So for that, what we need to do, we need to follow this first step. Okay. So for this type of section, we can't say directly by seeing that in that position the centroidal axis is there. So for that, what we need to do, we need to go through this procedure. Okay, so as you can see that CXX and CYY are the centroidal distance from that AB and AF. Okay, as you can see in the figure also. So first of all, what we need to do, we need to divide this section into two area. First A1, the below part, and the A2. Okay, so after that, what we need to do, we need to find out the area. I think all of you know how to find out the area of a rectangular section. It is nothing but L into B, is it? So for particular these two sections, the dimensions are given. So what is the A1 and what is the A2, we can easily find out by this procedure. So all of you please go through that, okay, step by step. You can also use your copy to writing down if you have any confusion. So first of all, we need to find out this area of both the section. we need to divide the section into two part, A1 and A2. After that, we have find out that area. Okay, so what is our A1? It's nothing but 13 into 10. Similarly for A2, it is 20 into 10. In the left side, as you can see, this dimension is 30, but we have divided the section into two part. So we need to consider the above part. For the A2 part, that distance is 20 into 10. So like this, we have calculated the area for both the section. Now, what we need to find out? We need to find out the exact position of the centroid. For that, we need to find out the coordinate of the whole section. Okay. So for that, there is two formula, as you can see here, X and Y. How we need to find out these two? So all of you please check the formula. How we need to find X? X is nothing but, so the formula is given, A1 into X1 plus A2 into X2 by A1 plus A2. Okay. So we have already calculated A1 and A2. So there is no need of calculation again. So we need to find out that X1 and X2 only. Okay. So for that, what we need to find out? See, X1 and X2, Y1 and Y2 is nothing but the distance from the line AB and AF, okay, the center distance. So if you consider that A1 area, what is our X1? So you can easily say that half of that portion, it is 30, so half of that is 15. So like that, X2 also need to find out. What is that X2? Also, please check this, how we have calculated. It is also given in the below, the figure below Z1 and Z2. That is the coordinate of that two point. In A1 area and A2 area, if you consider two points, Z1 and Z2, that coordinate of both the section is nothing but half of the section. So x axis it is distance 5, in x axis it is 15, in y axis it is 5. Similarly for Z2 area, in x axis it is 5 and for y axis it is 20. Okay, so just putting that value x1 x2 y1 y2, we can easily find out that x and y. So this x and y is nothing but that cxx and cyy. So by finding out that, we can now say where is our centroidal axis. It is at a distance of 11 mm from that section below AB. When we name that section as AB and AF in the below part and the left side. So from that, we can now easily say that our centroid is at a distance of 11 mm. So as you can see here, this figure, we have drawn that centroidal axis, X and Y axis. First of all, what we did, we consider that X and Y axis, it is in that section itself, in the below line and the in the left side line, but it is not actually in that position. So after finding out the CXX and CYY, we can now easily say that our centroid is at a distance of 11 mm. As you can see here in this figure, it is CYY is written below and CXX is written in the left side. That is the distance of 11 mm. So that G, I think all of you are able to see that G point. That G is our centroidal position, and that coordinate is 11 and 11. Okay. So after this, what is our second step? So for the second step, what we need to find out? We need to find out that moment of inertia about the Cartesian axis. Cartesian axis is our X and Y. Remember that, and that U and V is the principal axis. Okay, there is two axes, one is Cartesian axis, one is principal axis. So about the Cartesian axis, now we are going to find out. For that, if we find out about the X axis, what is the formula? The formula is given here, all of you can see that IX is equal to, the formula is given, moment of A1 plus A1 into H1 squared plus moment of A2 plus A2 into H2 squared. Okay, so I think all of you know how to find out the moment of inertia of a rectangular section. What is the formula? It is nothing but B d cube by 12. So for that part, You can easily say that for both the section, what will be the moment of inertia? It is for the below section, it is 13 to 10 cube by 12. It's very simple. Then next part, plus A1 into H1 square. For that part, what is the A1? We have already calculated that A1 also, it is simply 300. But there is a thing, H1. So all of you listen this carefully, okay? We need to understand how we have calculated this H1. As you can see in this figure, in the right side, H1 is written. I think all of you are able to see that H1 is written in this right side. Below the Cartesian axis, X, it is distance H1 is given. So that is the distance we need to find out. For that, how can we able to find out? It's very easy to find out. From the below to the x-axis, it is the distance of 11. The section is 10 mm dimension. So half of that dimension, if we minus from that 11, we can easily say that the height of that h1. So that 11 minus 5 will give you that h1. Okay. Similarly, we need to do for the next section. For that section, we already know for that A2 area, we know how to find out that moment of inertia. It is BD cube by 12 again. So 10 is our B, D is 20. So BD cube by 12, we can easily find out from that. Similarly, A2, we can easily say it's already we have calculated. So with that, now we need to find out that H2. Okay. So H2, what is that H2? So we need to find out that H2. As you can see, it is simple. Again, it is the 20 from the 20 distance. We need to minus that 11, the centroidal distance. After that, we can easily find out that H2 also. So after putting this value, we can easily say that I-axis is how much, okay? As it is an equal angle section, L section, both the section have the same dimension. So you can directly say IX section, IYY is equal. As you can see here, equal distance, equal value will come out after calculation. You can also do the calculation, or you can directly say that IXS is equal to IYY also. For your understanding here, I have given that calculation part. But for in exam, if you get the equal angle, you can directly write IXX after finding out IXX, the same value for IYY also, okay? So after finding out this, we need to find out the product moment of inertia for XY axis. That is nothing but IXY. And this is given by this formula, AXY. And this is if we divide it into two parts, as we are dividing the whole section into two parts, so we need to with again for the two parts, A1 into X1, Y1 plus A2 into X2, Y2, okay? So how we are able to know this X1, Y1, X2, Y2? Again, we need to find out by this, okay? We need to follow the Cartesian axis for sine convention, okay? I think all of you know that in which part, what is the sine convention, okay? As per the coordinate system. As you can see here also, it is in the right side, it is written. The first coordinate is always positive. In the next coordinate, it is negative, positive, then negative, negative, then positive, negative. Simple thing. These things you have already got in your school level itself. Okay. So by that, we need to check now where is our that G1 and G2. Okay. Here I think you have seen that G1 portion and that G2. See? In the A1 part and A2 part, there is two things written, G1 and G2. Okay, so here you check where is the G1 and where is the G2 as per the Cartesian axis. As you can see here, G1 is in our fourth coordinate and G2 is in our second coordinate. So as per that, we need to find out this values for G1 and G2, okay? So X1, X2, Y1 and Y2, we need to find out by following that sine convention from that Cartesian axis, what is the distance of that point, okay? And that G1 and G2 is the centroid, okay? Remember that G1 and G2, we need to consider the center of the section. As you can see here, G1 is in the right side of the Y axis. Why? Because that Y axis is at a distance of 11 mm from that left side of that portion, but our whole section is that is 30 mm. So for that 30 mm, half of that is 15 mm. So that CYY is left side of that Z1 portion, because Z1 at a distance of 15 mm. Similarly, in the G2 also, that ours G2 is at a distance of half of that section, but our CXS distance is 11, so it is below that G2. Okay, so remember that after finding out this C value, CXS and CY also, you can easily say where is our position G1 and G2 as per the dimension of the section. You need to draw that X and Y axis after finding out that CXX and CYY, so that you can easily say that where is your axis, and as per that axis, where is the centroidal position of both the section. Okay, so by that we need to find out these things. So after finding out this, all these things, you can easily put these things into IXY by putting all the value a1 x1 y1 a2 x2 y2, you can easily find out this IXY. So we have already got this formula, tan twice theta. So for in that formula, you simply put these values. A simple calculation, you will come to know the theta, what is the theta value. Okay, after this our one part is over. Okay, after this, what we need to find out, we need to find out the value of IUU and IPB. This is what, this is the moment of inertia about the principal axis. Okay, there is two axes, remember that. One is Cartesian axis, that X and Y, and there are another axis U and T, which is, you can see here in this figure, which is passing through that centroid also, U and T. It is two axes. Okay, so now we need to find out the moment of inertia about these two axes. For that also, we already know the formula how we need to find out. Earlier we did the derivation part. From that, we are going to use this formula. I think all of you got that formula. So just simply put all those values, all the values we have already calculated. Just we need to put here, and after calculating, we will find out this IUU and IVV. Okay, so all of you please go through the numerical ones. I think today the SAT option is not working. So is there any question? I am also not able to listen you. You are speaking. Okay, all of you please go through the numerical.
Hello, sir.
Yes, yes, please speak, and now I am able to hear you.
So from the derivation, I'm getting a different final answer.
Which one?
Sir, derivation, the final answer, IAU, principal axis.
Yes. What is the problem, again?
The final answer. Sir, the final answer, I'm getting something different.
That IU and IBB?
Yes, sir. In the PDF you gave us, you have this numerator, but my final answer, there is no numerator.
Oh, no, it will definitely come. You check that PDF, which I have given one handwritten PDF, na?
Yes, sir.
You check that, okay, in that. All are doing in step-by-step procedure. If you follow, yes, that,
sir. I think, sir, but in the derivation there's a numerator. Yes. But now this question you gave us in the final formula we use for this numerical, now also the final answer is different from derivation. In this numerical which we use now, the final IU and IVV in the numerical is different from the derivation. It's not same.
It is the same. You see, just check. We have just taken out that half outside. In the numerical.
No. So I'm talking of in the derivation, we have in the numerator we have I square XY. But in the numerical now, it's not there. And I'm getting something like that also. So just see the formula of the numerical and derivation is different.
Just a second. You are saying about that IUU and IVV, na?
Yes, sir.
Okay, but I think it is the same thing, IUU and IVV.
So in the derivation we have I square xy divided by square root of
yes
of this, but in the numerical is different. That I square xy in the numerator is not there, and I'm getting the same answer like that.
In the final, what you have got in the finally what you have got in the IVU value.
So in the IU, I got IXX plus IYY by 2 minus square root of I square XY plus IYY minus IXX by 2 whole square.
It is the same thing in the book also.
So in derivation, we have a numerator. We have a numerator in that part. But in the numerical also, you see, there's no numerator in that part. It will be cancelled out.
Okay, let me check this. Okay, I'm not able to get exactly what you are trying to say.
Okay, sir.
Because what we did in the last year, we got the same thing. As you can see in the class notes. Is in different in the class notes. That PDF file what I have given to you. Is it not the same, Michael, or it is different?
Sir, the formula in the derivation which we use. And the formula which we use in the numerical, it's different, sir.
Okay. I'm getting it. Okay, there may be some mistakes. Okay, in the check, I need to check. Okay, wait, just wait. You have got this formula now. After derivation, you have got that IXX plus IY by 2.
Yes, okay. Sir. Then square then root. There's no numerical. Minus, the next minus square root of I.
Yeah, square minus XY. Square root of IY minus
square root of.
Yeah, square root of I square xy plus IY minus IX by 2 into whole square. You have got these things? Is it?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. There's no. Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, that same thing we need to use in the numerical. Are we using different things?
Yes, sir. No,
I think we are using the same value in the numerical also.
Sir, yeah, we use that value in numerical, but in derivation, the one in that copy is different. In derivation, the final answer in PDF is different, sir.
Okay, Michael, I will talk to you regarding this. Okay, I think I am not able to get it because in my what I am seeing in my PDF, because here the same value is there, IUU. I think in the derivation, also, I think in which page number, can you tell me the page number? I think 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, in the 7 number page.
No, sir, page
before,
8.
Before similarly, I think one is what is written as similarly IVV. For that, you check that IUU. That same thing, it is used in the numerical also.
Okay, sir.
Okay, you just try to do it once again, okay? Because it must become same, okay? It have to become
okay,
same.
Okay, sir.
Regarding this numerical, yeah, is there any doubt here? Anyone have this? You can ask me, okay? And in the PDF, there is one assignment numerical. Okay, same thing, same for the same type of angle, just the dimension is different. You try to solve that, okay, by your own. It's also there in the book also. If you try to solve one by yourself, you can easily understand what you need to do actually.
Okay, sir.
Okay, is there anyone stay outside are not able to connect to the meeting because only 41 students are there. Don't leave the meeting, okay? I need to mark your attendance. Because today the start option is not working. I need to mark my name, okay? I'll be please stay for a while. Don't leave. Meanwhile, if you have any doubt, please feel free to ask, okay? Are you all there or you were just simply joining and leave the meeting? Is anyone please respond? Are you here? If it is like that, I will ask you to turn on your video, okay?
Okay, sir.
I am also not seeing you from a while. You can also turn on a video if you want.
Sir, college कब से खुलेगा वापस?
हाँ.
College open कब से हो रहा है sir?
हाँ, college तो हो जाएगा. ये सब क्या हो रहा है हम लोग को भी पता नहीं.
ऐसा कुछ ये dates मालूम है आप लोगों को?
एक second रुको हाँ बात करते हैं रुको थोड़ा recording stop कर